breast cancer awareness program. Please know that you will find comfort in our prayers or in something that we may share in song, worship, praise, and as we expound on the Word of God. Let us pray. Dear Lord, make of heaven and earth, we give thanks and we celebrate you as we walk and live by your power. Lord, we bow before you, thanking you, dear God, for everything. God, we thank you for always, always blessing us at all times. Lord, we give you all the glory and honor, and we give you all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for joining us. We're going to break today.
Honor, I give you grace. Church. My name is Miranda. I'm one of the nurses at More Healthy Family Medical Clinic, and I just want to encourage all ladies to see your doctor and get your mammogram scheduled. Thank you.
Shut up, sit up, break every chain. To break every chain.
Pentecostal church that would say, I am free.
Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. And it says in the word, wherefore seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witness, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us. And let us run this race with patience and the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. Mm-hmm. Praise God for the word. Oh, yeah. And my message today says, chains hinder your race. Chains hinder your race. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Just listening to the Break Every Chain song just reminds us, just seeing all the chains being broken. God is always faithful to his word. And every chain that is placed upon you is not to inflict you or to stop you from getting where God wants you to be. But it's to push you into your destiny. It's to push you into the direction that God would have you to go in. Saints of God, God is busy in this season. And I am going to break down this in three simple steps that we must do to be able to run this race without these chains on us. After we break our chains, we got to realize that, yeah, chains are going to be there sometimes. Chains are going to be there to try to stop us from getting where we're going. But we got to have three simple steps. Number one, hallelujah, encouragement. I did a sermon way back about a couple of months ago that says you got to encourage yourself. Yes. Saints of God, you got to realize that even when David was stuck in Ziklag and he didn't have nowhere else to go and everybody turned against him, he had to encourage himself. Sometimes when you got so much going on in your life, it's hard for you to encourage yourself. But you can pull out into everybody else, but you can't seem to be able to encourage yourself, to be able to motivate yourself to do what God wants you to do. Yeah. But I'm here to just be a witness for you that I had to encourage myself a couple of times when I was down and out and didn't have nobody else to turn to. But all I had to do was open up this Bible that had black and white letters in it, and God encouraged me through the word of God. God said, turn to this chapter and read about me in Psalms 23, where I am your shepherd. He said, turn to this chapter in John where you can see I walk with people, I talk with people, and I showed them what I needed them to do, and I never left them, even through their persecution and their trials. He said, turn to the book of Revelations and see what's to come. But it's not to shake my people or to break you down. It's to let you know that this is a warning of what's to come. Yes. Praise God. And I thank God for the word. Some of us like to run to people for our encouragement. But God told me, run to my word. Yes. He also said, pray and seek my face. Yes. He also said, fast. We got to be able to cut loose some things and fast so we can find God and he can meet us where we are, people. We thank and praise God for the word in the name of Jesus. And I thank and praise God for the encouragement, because sometimes we can get caught in our why. And I often hear people say, why am I going through this? Why am I dealing with this? Why am I having hard times with this and that, my family, my finances, whatever it is? We get stuck in the why. And God talked to me on the way here when I was praising God in my car. And he said, ask them, why did they choose me? Why did you choose to let me in your life? Why did you think I left you in the times that you were there and I was walking with you? Matter of fact, when you thought you was walking by yourself, I was carrying you. Ask them why they don't want to run to my word. Why they don't want to bend on their knees and get down and seek my face. Why they can't turn away from the plate and fast and pray. He said, ask them why. Ask them what their why is. And when you establish why you chose God to be your Lord and Savior, you won't even have to worry about these other why worries. All the other why worries just go out, because you'll be seeking God. God, what is it you want me to do? Your why will turn to a what. Your why will no longer be your why. It'll be a what. God, what is it you want me to do? I see you getting my attention through this trial right here. I see you trying to change my focus through this tribulation, God. What is it you need me to do? What is it you need me to do? That's the encouragement part. But then he says, lay aside every weight. All those chains that's laying on the floor right now, it's your weight that has been dropped off of you. God peels the layers off. You're like an onion. God got to come back and peel every little layer off of you to get to where he really needs to be. But guess what? To start a chain, you got to have one link. All those links begin to link to that one. So if you got a heart that has something of unforgiveness, before you know it, depression clings on to it. Before you know it, anxiety clings on to it. Before you know it, all these other bad things tend to link on to that one link. But when God came and he said, you know what, all these sins I gave my life for, you are free. All these chains that you feel like are holding you down, you are free. You no longer have to hold these chains. These chains are what's holding you back. This is why you can't run your race. It's because you're holding on to some chains. Have you ever tried to put on a whole lot of weights? Anybody ever tried that? All right, the military and me being a member of the armed forces, they make us put on jackets and rucksacks and all this stuff. And they tell us, walk as fast as you can. They don't never tell us to run. They say, walk as fast as you can and see how far you can go. Your number one obstacle is to make 10 miles in this amount of time. Well, you know, ain't nobody going to walk if they got to make it in a time. When a time is set out there, nobody's going to walk. But when you have this weight on you and you're trying to run, it seems like your feet get heavy. Before you know it, you start slowing down. Your knees hurt. Your back hurt. Before you know it, you got a headache. Your shoulders hurt. Your feet definitely going to hurt. But you got to imagine yourself. I got to get to the end point. I got to get there in this amount of time. No matter how heavy this weight is, each mile I get to, it's going to get heavier. It's going to get heavier. But guess what? God said, I got you. I'm going to pick this weight up. I'm going to pick it up so that you can run. Before you know it, you got a little trot in your step. Before you know it, you're beginning to get a little faster. And I just want you all to know that sometimes when your chains are breaking off, sometimes it's for you to pick your feet up. And that's your picking, that's picking your feet up in praise. Because some of us like to sit down on God. I'm telling you, when God starts breaking chains in your life, you got to be able to stand up and just take little baby steps. You just got to move one foot at a time. Before you know it, you're running. This is not a sprint to the end. God said it's an endurance. You got to be able to take this one step at a time. This is a slow race to the mark. You can't sprint there no matter how hard you try. No matter how good you think you are and you live in a Christian life, God has some things set aside for you that he wants you to do. And you got to keep him in the midst of it all. So when you lay aside all these heavy weights and the sins that are bogging us down, whether it's gossip, whether it's lying, whether it's being deceitful, whether it's throwing things out there that we know is a stumbling block for others, we need to recognize these things that are linking together in our lives that's stopping us from getting where we really need to be. So we got to lay aside every weight. We got to drop off the sin and recognize the people of God. We want to know, and we ought to know, when God is leading us in one direction or another, when we got to walk that way. The chains can't stop you from getting there. The chains can only delay you in your destination. Mm-hmm. That's all it can do. Only you can let these chains hinder you. But the God I serve, yeah. The God that I walk with, the God that I talk to, the God that I lean and depend on, the God that I know for myself, set me free. Woo! I'm telling you right now, ain't nothing better than him. Because now instead of me running to my problems and talking to everybody else about it, I said, Lord, I thank you. Homosexuality or addiction, but God said, just in case you do, I got somebody right here in this word, somebody called Jesus. I'm gonna send somebody to see about you, I'm gonna send somebody to take you out of that, I'm gonna send somebody to deliver you and give you a word, dust you off, and put you on the solid foundation in the name of Jesus. Woo, his word is true, people. His word is true. Thank you, Jesus, for the word of God. It's a race. Yeah. It's a slow, long endurance race. You know, they always tell us in the military, you got to get your endurance up before you run this 2 miles. You got to prepare. You got to practice. You got to move forward. You can't look back. If you walk and discourage yourself from walking, you got to run the whole 2 miles. But I tell you right now, God says sometimes you might have to take a rest. But that don't mean your rest is to sit down and be static. That means your rest is to take little steps. I need you to slow your steps down just a little bit, but keep moving. Praise God.
Yes.
My last and final thought, keep your eyes on Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Keep your eyes on Jesus.
Yes.
When you run the race, you don't never look back to see who behind you. That's only because you think you far enough ahead when you think you can stop and look back. Are you that good? But when you focus on Jesus, woo, hallelujah. You get to step over them chains. You get to step over them hurdles. You get to step over them trials and tribulations. Because I'm looking up high. I'm looking for the mighty and the one and only true God. I'm looking for him and I'm seeking his face in everything. And I thank and praise God because I know he's going to lead me to the mountaintop. He's going to be the one to take me and place my feet on the high ground. He's going to be the one to say, Felicia, you know what, baby? Don't worry about what's going on around you. We're in a season right now when people stuck at home and they're going through depressions. They're going through anxiety. The killing and homicide rate and increase because people have took their eyes off of God. We want to focus on our government right now instead of focusing on the one true living God. The one true almighty God. The God that said we're going to get up today and walk around. The God that said I'm going to let this air be fresh for you to breathe. The God that said, you know what, when a storm come, I'm going to give you warning. People going to know the storm coming. I thank God for the all true and living God. Because he's the God who says, I'm going to press this whole thing in order. We just got a little pandemic coming on. But guess what? This pandemic is to place some stuff in order right now. This pandemic is to teach us how to pray. This pandemic is to teach us how to get out and walk the streets. Go visit our neighbors. Baby, you need something. This pandemic is for us to call and have a conversation with somebody and not text. This pandemic is to make us reach out and touch our loved ones, to reach someone who's hurting in this season, to help somebody along. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I thank you for the pandemic right now, God, because you're teaching me how to reach people, and I would never even reach right now, God. Oh, Father, I thank you. Father, we thank you that you allow us to continue to have church. That we continue to praise God. That we continue to meet in this place. I thank you, Lord, because if it was not for you, I don't know where I would be. Saints of God, I'm here to tell you, your faithfulness to your family, your faithfulness to your friends, your faithfulness, number one, to God, is what's going to make it through. We got to see 2020 out. and 2021 coming in. And God said, this is a new season. I'm about to stir up your life. This is a new season. Keep focus on me. This is a new season. If you keep your eyes on me, you'll see your destiny. And you'll see windows open up and blessings pour out. In the name of Jesus. I'm coming swiftly to a close. In the name of Jesus. And I was on my way in, and I was listening to this song, praise God. And the song said, if the Lord hasn't done anything else for me, he's done enough. If the Lord has not done anything else for me, he's done enough. Saints of God, God is faithful in what he said he was going to do. All you got to do is when you're feeling lost, when you're feeling confused, when you're feeling like you're all by yourself and you can't go on, black and white, open up that Bible, sit down, find you a quiet space, and use the tools God has given you. Pray, fast, seek his face, find you meditation, solidarity, somewhere where you can focus on the Lord God all by himself. Don't let anyone distract you or deter you from him. And watch God move in your life. Amen. This is the word from God. Praise God. Amen. We thank you. We thank you. So if there's anyone out there who has not received the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, and you have allowed this message to touch your life, and you realize your endurance is not where it needs to be right now. You have these chains on you that you can't break. Please, please, reach out to us. Yeah. Give us a call. We're here to focus on you. We're here to help you. At Pilgrim Branch Missionary Baptist Church, mb.org. Thank you so much. And please reach out to us.